The code of conduct, all the stuff that you wanna hear about, I recognize you from somewhere, I don't remember.
The freshman, like, freshman seminar thing.
The orientation?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, that was it, okay, I should know all of you, right? Are you related to Alexis?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, twin?
No, ma'am.
Okay, almost, okay, I see it. I'm looking at some town.
There's a sister we could pick on.
Yeah.
This broadens my horizons.
So your faculty members have asked me to talk to you about Title IX, does anybody know what that's, what Title IX is? You probably know for a different reason.
Well, yeah, for a different reason.
And what do you know about it for?
Well, that females have like the right to do exactly what males can do, as in sports related.
So that's how Title IX was, people first got to know Title IX. Title IX is one of the acts of the Higher Education Act of 1972, so back in the day, people really knew about Title IX, so female students would have the equal access to sporting, to finances that you get for sports. But more recently, Title IX has come into the news and come into our attention on college campuses because of gender-based discrimination that often, that most likely occurs, or that people know about with, in the area of sexual assault or sexual discrimination, harassment, those kind of things. So the language is that Title IX guarantees, I'm gonna read it because I wanna make sure I get it right. It's a federal civil rights law that prohibits gender-based discrimination and sexual misconduct in education. So what that means is that Cecil College and every college, university, and K-12 school has to be actively engaged in making sure that, students aren't discriminated against because of their gender. So that means that, for example, if you are, if somebody is giving you unwanted sexual attention, that you, know, kind of harassing you in class, wants to go out with you, wants in a relationship with you that you're not interested in, you can come to me or to someone else in the college and say, this is making me uncomfortable. If someone is stalking you, cyber stalking, that's often how that manifests itself on our campus as well. So it's important that all of our students know that that regulation is in place, that we are very actively engaged in making sure that students know about that. That's what this is. In fact, if you want to take one and pass it back. Hopefully you might have gotten this when you came to new student orientation or when you got your student planner. So we have a policy on how you report sexual misconduct. If you don't want to report something officially, we have confidential reporters that you can see on here. We are very lucky here at Cecil College that we don't have a lot of instances of students needing to talk with me about this. But we also try and make sure that students know that there are things that they can do as students if they want to, get involved in making sure that it's a secure campus. Like if you see something, say something. I don't know. In some of the classrooms, there are posters on the wall that talk about things that you can do. I'll be back to put something in here. But you can see on the back, if you know something, like if you see something that's just not quite right, if you see someone being subject to some harassment or something, you can come and say to me, you know, I saw something and it just didn't feel right to me. I was the victim of something and it didn't, you know, it didn't feel right. That's what I'm here for in my role as the Title IX coordinator. Any questions about that? And there's some resources on here. There's also a page on my Cecil about sexual misconduct and Title IX. And we are in the process of getting an online training and awareness campaign module for students as well. So any questions about that? It's kind of dry stuff until you need us, and we're very happy to work with students. In fact, as the Title IX coordinator, I can issue something called a no contact order. So if students if somebody is, again, unwanted sexual attention, I can issue a letter that says, you know, cease and desist, don't do that to that student. And then we have a dialogue about what to do about that. So there's always due process in this process. It's dry stuff, but it's important that you know about that. And if any of you are transferring to a four-year school, this kind of manifests itself a little bit more when you have students in residence halls who are, you know, partying and doing things that might not be the most responsible thing often comes up as well. Any questions about that? The other thing that I do, I'm the conduct officer for the college, and you just should all make sure that you know that there is a student code of conduct, that if you violate the code of conduct, you also get to come and talk with me. There's due process here, so it's okay, don't worry, I'm really pretty approachable. And we do like to keep students on campus, so we make sure that students know that if they've done something wrong, we explain to them what that is, let them know how they can remedy that, and try and keep them on campus too. Yes?
This may be something that you intend to address later, so if it is, but I'm just, when you talk about the process of due process, I'm wondering if you could maybe explain to students a little bit what it's like to be the accused as well as the accuser.
Okay.
What rights does the accused have?
Okay. We're going to be rewriting our code of
yes.
conduct, but right now our students have, this is an administrative system, so our code of conduct is not like the courts, but they're similar in that you students who are charged with violating our code of conduct get a letter from me that says, I've gotten a report that says you, I'll take something very minor, so that you were charged with knocking over a trash can in the quad area. That would be disruptive to the campus. So I send an email that said, or a letter that says, you know, come and talk to me about that. And we just talk about it. You know, this is what public safety told me happened. What do you think happened? Did you trip over the can? Did you do this? We have a dialogue. If the student is, says, I'm not responsible for doing that, public safety says they are responsible for doing that, we have a meeting, and I listen to what public safety might say, and listen to what the accused student might say. And those people get to ask questions of one another. There's a process, but it's a relatively informal meeting. And then as the conduct officer, I make a decision about what should happen. And some of the things that can happen, again, according to our code of conduct, I should have these all in my head. You can be suspended from a particular class. You can be suspended from the college for a period of 1 or 2 years, for a time period. You could be expelled from the institution, which means you can never come back, which is a pretty severe infraction. You could be required to pay restitution. So if you damaged something on the campus but still remained a student, you would have to pay for, you know, if you broke a window, you might have to do that. So that's that process. One of the comforting things for me is there's also a grievance procedure. So if I make a decision as the hearing officer that the student doesn't like, the student can grieve my decision, and that goes to the vice president for student services, who can look at what I've done and look and say, you know, you made a good decision or you made a bad decision. So, is that the detail
yes.
that you were looking
Thank
for?
You.
So it's always important that students know that they have rights and responsibilities. So you have rights on the campus, but you also have the responsibility to use your voice to respond to things if that has to happen. Any questions? I'm happy to say that I haven't seen any of you in that capacity. To be honest, we have about maybe 2 or 3 issues a month that require my attention. That's increased in the past year. But it's a learning experience for students, and I think that's important. You know, college isn't like high school. And some people don't understand the differences. So I'm here to try and explain that the best I can. And again, keep people in their classes and moving forward with their education. Any questions? Is that good? My 10 minutes are up. Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.